Hey Siri, what's the weather like in New York tomorrow?
Expect partly cloudy skies in New York tomorrow. The high will be 90 degrees, and the low will be 73.
And what about in San Francisco?
It should be hot and sunny in San Francisco, California tomorrow, with a high of 79 degrees.
And in Miami?
It doesn't look so nice in Miami, Florida tomorrow. Down to 82 degrees with thunderstorms.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
If you take a step back and think about this, do you realize that I just had an actual conversation with a non-living object? A few decades ago, computers could barely get past the basic functions of a machine, let alone talk to a human. But with the rise of natural language processing, it all changes. But what gives the computer the power to actually understand the sounds of a person and make sense out of it all? Well, this is possible thanks to the powerful subfield of AI called speech recognition. And in this video, I'll walk you through what it is and how it works its magic. And as always, don't forget to download the interactive PDF linked in the description below so that you can take valuable notes on key points to take away from this video and add to your collection of cheat sheets. Let's get started. So broadly, speech recognition allows for the recognition and translation of spoken words into text. The most famous examples of a speech recognition software are smart speakers, like Siri, as you saw in the beginning of the video. Another example of a speech recognition software is the infamous Google Translate, which might help you with your Spanish homework every now and then. But you might still be wondering how all of this actually happens. I mean, how can a computer actually recognize your speech? Well, speech recognition works by breaking down audio into individual sounds, converting these sounds into a digital format, and using algorithms and models to find the most probable word fit in that language. To better understand this, let's dig deeper on each of these steps. So when people speak, they create vibrations in the air. A device known as the analog-to-digital converter transforms the sound wave into binary data that the machine can understand. The ADC also filters the sound to remove unnecessary noise and normalizes the sound and speed of the speech to match the pre-recorded samples in the machine's device. It then separates the data into different bands of frequency, which the spectrogram then analyzes further. On the x-axis there is time, and the y-axis plots the frequency of a sound, as in high pitches versus low pitches. You see, all words are made up of distinct vowel sounds that each have different frequencies, which are recorded on this device. The areas that are brighter signify high frequencies, and the areas that are darker signify low ones. All vowel sounds have different frequency patterns, which can be pre-programmed into the computer, allowing it to recognize when a spoken sound matches a specific vowel sound. These here are known as phonemes, which are the smallest elements of a language that make up its base. The computer then runs these phonemes through complex models that compare them to words in its pre-built dictionary. But there's a catch. Human language isn't so simple. We all know that humans speak with different accents, slangs, mispronunciations, and these variations aren't in a computer's dictionary. Well, this is where models such as the hidden Markov model come in. Now, models such as these are too complex to fully understand in this video, so we'll get to these in later videos when we talk about machine learning and neural networks. But for now, just know that speech recognition uses models such as the hidden Markov model to understand the intricacies of our human language. So coming back to the smart speaker example that we began with, we now know how Siri was able to understand the sounds coming out of my mouth. But how was she able to understand the exact meaning and context of my words and respond back with valuable output? Well, this is where natural language processing comes in, which we discussed in my last video. After speech recognition, it is up to NLP to figure out the exact meaning and purpose of the human's words. Now, let's look at another example.
I saw a case study on Coursera on how a smart speaker works, and I want to walk you guys through this. If you'd like to check out this course, I've included a link to it in the description.
Let's walk through exactly how Alexa works, which can be broken down into four steps. So let's say that you want Alexa to tell you a joke. The first step is trigger word detection, and in this case, that'd be Alexa. This means that whenever Alexa hears this phrase, it knows that a command is coming next. Alexa is programmed with an algorithm that will take in a phrase said by the human as input and output either a 0 or a 1, depending on whether or not the phrase matches Alexa. Next, Alexa will use speech recognition to detect the next words after Alexa. It will then translate this audio into a text transcript. Intent recognition is the next step, which is where Alexa will use NLP to figure out exactly what you are telling it to do, or your intent. it will use another algorithm that takes in your words as input and matches it to one of the operations in a pre-programmed list. Lastly, Alexa will execute your command, in this case, telling you a joke. To respond back with words, it would use speech synthesis, which is essentially the opposite of speech recognition.
So the next time you ask Alexa to play some music or tell you a joke, you know exactly how she's doing it. Now, Alexa, as you know, is a bot that you can have voice conversations with. But there are also some virtual assistants that you can chat with without any voice interaction. And these are most commonly known as messenger chatbots. Messenger chatbots are often easier and more effective to build, as they don't require pre-recorded speech responses to user queries. So, in the next few videos, I'm going to be introducing you to the world of chatbots, as well as a free platform on which you can actually build one yourself, no coding required. And if you've enjoyed learning about speech recognition in this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and comment down below what kind of voice assistants or text chatbots you use in your daily life. And if you're new here, then make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss any videos that'll help you on your journey towards mastering artificial intelligence. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.